News Review from BBC Learning English.
Hello and welcome to News Review, the programme where we show you how to use the language from the latest news stories in your everyday English. Hi, I'm Neil. Joining me today is Dan.
Hello.
So, Dan, what's our story?
It's a story about a global virus, but it won't make you sick.
A virus that won't make you sick.
Hmm.
Very interesting. Let's find out some more from this BBC World Service News Bulletin.
Experts in cybersecurity are warning of a possible new wave of malware attacks around the world when people return to work after the weekend. More than 120,000 systems in about 100 countries are estimated to have been infected on Friday. The disruption has hit users, including government offices, car manufacturers, banks and health services. The malware prevents access to computer data and demands a ransom to lift the block.
So, starting last Friday and continuing through the weekend, a nasty computer virus has infected and spread across a large number of countries through their computer systems. This has affected major organizations, including governments, health services, and industry. The virus blocks access to the computer.
Okay, well, this has been a massive story over the last few days. You've been scanning the news websites and looking for the words and expressions people need to understand and to be able to talk about this story. So what have you found?
I certainly have. So I've found surge, ransomware, and stopped in its tracks.
Surge, ransomware, and stopped in its tracks. Okay, let's start with that first one, Dan. What's the headline?
So our first headline comes from The Independent and says, cyber attack. Fears of surge in ransomware infections as people return to work on Monday.
Okay, so surge there, meaning sudden increase.
Exactly. Suddenly and greatly increasing. And it's very related to water. Think of the expression a tidal surge. This is when the seawater suddenly rises onto the land and nobody expected it.
Okay, we don't just use it when we're talking about water these days, though, do we?
No, we don't. You can also talk about power, as in electricity, surge in power. When might that happen?
Yeah, so for example, when there's a TV program that huge numbers of people are watching at the same time, let's say a football match, and it's halftime or there's a break for the adverts, lots of people in the United Kingdom at least will make a cup of tea and put on their kettles, and there'll be an electricity surge.
Exactly like that. And we can also do surges of emotion, like a surge of joy or a surge of interest. Prices may surge due to economic factors. And of course, people, sudden movement of people, like Oxford Circus at rush hour.
For example, our nearest tube, that's an underground train system in London, is Oxford Circus. It's one of the busiest in the city.
Yeah.
And at going home time, there's a surge of people. Sometimes they have to shut the gates to too many people trying to get down into that tunnel.
It can also be used as a verb. So as well as saying the surge of people pushing into the station, we can say the people surged into the station. And as a general rule of thumb, we use surge plus in with a noun and surge plus of with an emotion.
Okay, thanks for that. Our next headline. And with the word ransomware.
Our second headline comes from the BBC News and says, Microsoft warns ransomware cyber attack is a wake-up call.
Okay, so ransomware, a virus designed to stop a computer working unless money is paid.
Yes, it's a very nice word, and it's a portmanteau, which means it's two words smashed together to make one word. And we actually heard another one in the bulletin. It was malware. Malware is a combination of the word malicious, meaning bad or evil, and ware coming from software, which is a computer program. Ransomware is like malware. Except that ransomware is more specific. We use the ware from software, but we have ransom as in the money that you must pay to return the victim of a kidnapping.
Yes, okay. This is an extremely modern word. In fact, I think I'd never used this word until about 3 days ago, and now it's everywhere, which is the great thing about News Review. we can take these words.
We're on the cutting edge of vocabulary.
It's been around a few years, however.
That's right. So because of the current level of technology, these kind of programs and this kind of malware, these viruses, they're emerging more and more. You wouldn't have heard this, say, 20, 30 years ago. It just didn't exist. But brand new modern word.
Okay, ransomware. Next, our final headline.
Our final headline comes from news.com.au and says, Marcus Hutchins named as man who stopped global cyber attack in its tracks.
Okay, so stopped in its tracks, stopped moving or doing something.
That's right.
Suddenly. Mm. Yeah, okay. Now I'm a bit confused here, Dan. You know how it is.
I do. Tell me.
I thought tracks were marks that you made on the ground when you walked.
Exactly that. And you're right. Tracks are the footsteps that you leave in a soft substance on the floor, for example, snow. Now imagine you're walking through a forest in the snow, and every step you take, you leave a footprint. Mm-hmm. These are your tracks. They show where you've been and where you may be going. However, suddenly you see a bear. Mm-hmm. What do? You stop. Mm-hmm. And you stop in your tracks. Your feet are in exactly the last position that they were.
Yeah.
And this is quite common. It's a sort of a surprise move, things like that. People get stopped in their tracks.
So why are we using this to talk about a software, piece of malicious software?
Well, because it's the abrupt halt of the computer virus and the spread. Somebody found a way to stop it moving forwards.
Yeah.
Okay. If it helps, I heard another story that's related, but it may or may not be true. Think of it like this. Trains run on tracks. Mm-hmm. They show where the train has been and where it will be going. If I want to stop the train to rob it, I need to stop it in its tracks. I might push over a tree and will abruptly stop the train from moving forward.
Okay. Very useful expression, used widely.
That's right.
Have you ever been stopped in your tracks, Dan?
I have once, yes. My wife stopped me in my tracks. First time I saw her, actually. I came round a corner and saw her for the first time, and she hit me a bit like a train. I was in love at first sight.
Wow, Dan. Before this gets too mushy, I think we need to move on to our Facebook challenge.
Writer.
Okay, so ransomware, as we've discussed, is a portmanteau word, meaning a word made from two other words put together. Which two words form the word ransomware? Okay, so we put that out there on Facebook, and the options were A, ran and somewhere, so ran somewhere, B, ransom and beware, or C, ransom and software. What was the response?
Again, the response was overwhelmingly positive. I think we're going to have to start writing
making
more
it harder.
Difficult questions. Yeah. They're too clever out there. So everybody who said the answer is C, you are correct. Well done, Mohammed A. Abu Hadida. Well done, Hirokazu Kondo. Well done, Shupil Babu Udash, Sabah, Durdana, Laurent, Tri, and everybody else who said C. Good job, everybody.
Yes, well done. And Dan, now can you just recap the words we've been looking at today?
Certainly. The first word we had was surge, which is a sudden increase. Then ransomware, a virus designed to stop a computer working unless money is paid. And finally, stopped in its tracks, which is stop moving or doing something suddenly.
Yes, well, we're going to have to stop this program in its tracks because we've run out of time. But if you'd like to test yourself on today's vocabulary, there's a quiz you can take on our website, bbclearningenglish.com, where you can find all kinds of other videos and activities to help you improve your English. Thank you for joining us and goodbye.
Bye-bye.
News review from BBC Learning English.